Good day from Chem Help ASAP. Let's work some problems in which we need to calculate the formal charges of atoms. Check the video description to find links to the problems in this video as well as a solution set. There will be links during the video that will connect you to other relevant tutorials. Before starting the problems, let's review some ideas. First, second row elements, the kind that we see most often in organic chemistry, follow very predictable bonding patterns. That is, if the element satisfies the octet rule, then carbon tends to make four bonds, nitrogen makes three, oxygen two, and fluorine one. Second, if the atom has an extra bond above this normal value, then it will have a positive formal charge. We show positive charges with a plus sign in a circle next to the atom. If the atom has one too few bonds, it will have a negative formal charge. We show negative formal charges with a minus sign in a circle next to the atom. If an atom does not have a charge, we normally do not put any label next to the atom. When in doubt, however, always follow the style that your instructor uses. Carbon can break this trend, but it only happens if carbon violates the octet rule. And typically by violating, it only has six electrons in its valence. So since we're talking about violating the octet rule, technically, you could argue this is not an exception to the pattern that we see at the top of the slide. So let's get started. Here are our first problems. Let's just write in the corner a reminder. Carbon tends to make four bonds. Nitrogen's three. Oxygen two. And fluorine one. So in the left, we have our first compound. We have a carbon. This carbon has four bonds, as we'd expect. It has a full octet. That carbon is neutral. Here's an oxygen. This oxygen has one, two bonds, has two lone pairs. That is a full octet. That oxygen is neutral. Neither of those atoms, the carbon nor the oxygen, has a formal charge. Okay, let's go to the next structure. We're not worried about hydrogen. Hydrogen will always have a bond. Here is a carbon in the middle. That carbon has one, two, three, four bonds. One of these atoms has a double bond. That's okay. There are two lines. That's two bonds. So that carbon has four bonds. It has no formal charge. This oxygen has two bonds. They happen to be two bonds to the same atom, carbon, but that's all right. Those are two bonds, has two lone pairs. That is a full octet. So therefore, that oxygen does not have a formal charge. This oxygen in the bottom right, however, it has just one bond with a full octet. Now that breaks our rule of oxygen needing two bonds. If it has too few bonds, what we've done is we've lost a bond and replaced it with a lone pair. This oxygen has a negative charge. So let's go ahead and give it a negative charge, a minus in a circle. And now we've assigned all the formal charges for that particular structure. Now let's go to our next structure. We have a nitrogen. This nitrogen has four bonds. That is not what it's supposed to have. It's supposed to have three. It has a full octet. If it has four bonds, that's one too many bond. That means this nitrogen will have a positive formal charge. I'll write the plus within a circle. To the right, we have a fluorine. This fluorine has no bonds. It just has lone pairs. It has a full octet, but it has too few bonds, and therefore it has a negative formal charge. Okay, for the next questions, again, let's put in the upper left a listing of how many bonds we expect from all our atoms. Now, here we have our first structure on this slide. Here is a carbon. That carbon has one, two, three, four bonds. It has a full octet. That carbon has no formal charge, so we don't need to label it. This carbon connected to the oxygen, it also has four bonds. Two of those bonds are to the same atom, but that's four lines, four bonds. That's what we expect in carbon. There is no formal charge on that carbon. Finally, the rightmost carbon, this carbon has four bonds. Again, No formal charge on that carbon. How about the oxygen? The oxygen has two bonds, both to the carbon. It also has two lone pairs. It's a full octet. Two bonds with a full octet is what we expect to see in oxygen that does not have a formal charge. Okay, so there are no formal charges in this structure on the left. How about the next structure? It is almost identical. This CH3 group is the same in the middle as what we saw on the left. The carbonyl, the C and O, have exactly the same bonding, so there are no charges there. But this carbon to the far right has changed. So on this carbon, we have 1, 2, 3 bonds. That's 1 too few. We've replaced one with a lone pair. This is a case where carbon has, any atom has too few bonds. This happens to be carbon. It is going to have a negative formal charge. Okay, finally, let's look at the structure on the far right. This is just a little structure, two atoms. The nitrogen has a full octet, three bonds, and a lone pair that's a full octet. This nitrogen has the expected number of bonds, three, so that nitrogen does not have a formal charge. The carbon has a full octet with three bonds and a lone pair. It has too few bonds, therefore this carbon has a negative formal charge. Once again, as we look at these questions, let's go ahead and put in the upper left our expected number of bonds for each second row element. Great. Okay, so now our first structure here, we'll start with this oxygen on the left. This oxygen has a full octet, three lone pairs and a bond. It's 8 electrons, but it only has one bond. This oxygen has too few bonds. If you went through the proper formula charge counting equation, you would find that it has a negative formal charge. The carbons in this molecule, this carbon has 4 bonds and a full octet. No formal charge there. This carbon has 4 bonds and a full octet. 4 bonds, that's what we expect in carbon. No formal charge for that structure. Now going to the middle, this is a really odd looking structure, but actually this is a very common species encountered in organic chemistry. So let's tackle the nitrogen on the left. The nitrogen on the left has a full octet. It has 8 electrons in its valence, 2 lone pairs, and 2 bonds. But as a full octet nitrogen, it does only have the 2 bonds, to the middle nitrogen. Therefore, this nitrogen has too few bonds, and it is going to have a negative formal charge. The nitrogen on the far right has the same situation. It has a full octet, but only 2 bonds. Therefore, the formal charge for this nitrogen is going to be negative. So here is a species that has multiple atoms that have formal charges. This is not really common, but it does happen. Let's now tackle this nitrogen in the middle. This nitrogen has a full octet. It has 4 bonds. It's 8 electrons. But as a nitrogen with 4 bonds, it has too many bonds. Therefore, this nitrogen is actually going to have a positive charge instead. Now, this kind of structure is not common, where you see multiple formal charges next on adjacent atoms, but they can happen. This species is actually called azide. It is a really common anion. It's super useful in organic chemistry. And if you keep studying organic chemistry, you will encounter this anion with some frequency. Okay, let's go to this structure on the right. We'll look at the two left carbons, the two right carbons first. So this carbon has 4 bonds, just like we'd expect. That carbon is neutral. This carbon has 4 bonds, like we'd expect. That carbon is also neutral, has no formal charge. And then we get to this carbon that's furthest on the left. This carbon has only 3 bonds. Now that's not a terrible deal, but this carbon doesn't have a full octet. And you might say, how do we know that there's no lone pair on this structure? Well, all the structures in these problems are valid Lewis dot structures, which means if there's a lone pair, it has to be shown. This carbon doesn't have a lone pair because a lone pair is not drawn. So otherwise, it'd be breaking the rules of Lewis dot structures. So this carbon only has 6 valence electrons. So normally, by our previous thinking, you think, oh, this carbon has too few bonds. It only has 3 bonds. We expect to see 4 bonds, therefore this carbon should have a negative charge. But since it doesn't have a full octet, it's actually deficient electrons. And so here is a case that violates our thinking. This carbon has too few bonds, but because it doesn't have a full octet, it actually has a positive formal charge. This is an example of a carbocation. It is a cation, a positively charged species on carbon, carbocation, and these are important intermediates, as we will see later as we study more organic chemistry. At last, here is our final problem. Let's again write down our expected number of bonds for the second row elements that we most commonly encounter in organic molecules. Now let's look at our structure. Here's our nitrogen on the left. This nitrogen has three bonds, full octet. That's exactly what we expect. Therefore, this nitrogen is a neutral atom. This carbon has a full octet with four bonds. Four bonds is what we expect on carbon. Therefore, that carbon does not have a formal charge. Here is an oxygen. It has three bonds with a lone pair. That's a full octet for eight electrons. But this full octet oxygen has three bonds, not two. Therefore, this oxygen has too many bonds, and therefore it has a positive charge. So, as you work through these types of problems, as you work really even a small number of problems, hopefully you'll see the patterns in how organic atoms or atoms found in organic molecules typically bond. If you memorize a formal charge equation, that will work for you without fail. But there are just a handful of patterns you need to recognize to be able to quickly identify and correctly label formal charges on second row elements that are seen in organic molecules. I hope this video was helpful for you. Please subscribe, like, or leave a question or comment. Links to downloadable copies of these problems and solutions are in the video description. Thank you for watching.